My name's Daniel, I'm from Aylesbury. I've studied at Bath College. Really enjoying the course, learning the skilled trades and really and the traditional ways of working with stone.
Hi, my name's Ben McKinnell. I'm a student at Bath College. I'm doing stone masonry level 2. I travel up from Kent to take this course 2 days a week. And I've currently done 3 Portland stone projects and about to start a Bath stone plinth. I'm hoping that the course will at Bath College help me get a job in stone masonry.
As Ben's just mentioned, we're now moving on to working Bath stone. And Bath stone and Portland stone are completely 2 different methods, different types of tools. Although the working of mouldings, the methods are pretty much the same methods, but the tools are different. One big difference is Portland stone is, you've got to remember, chamfers first, and Bath stone is you cut your fillets first, because you're cutting them out with a fillet saw. So we're going to go ahead and get this marked out. This is the profile we're going to work through on the Bath stone. I'm just going to get this marked out. It lines up, we can use a drag to keep the section to the top bed and to the face of the stone. And scribe it on. That's the profile marked out. As I said, the first thing that we're going to be doing is taking out a check. When we mark the lines out for the check, I can mark them out with a marking drag, which will help to give us a line as a guide to using the handsaw, which we'll use with Bath stone. Give that extra little room for filling. We've got a handsaw, Bath stone handsaw. I'm actually sliding that drag line. I'm just going to finish off, clean this all cut up, this blank. Way of checking your cut. With a sinking square. Molding. little bits of shell that it hits, you can just tap the little bits of shell down with the drag. Stage is to take the Covetto parts out of the Simon Rector, and again we'll use the saw cut again, put the saw cut through the centre of the moulding, align that and align that. Okay. We've got those marks there, we can actually a guide to cut in two drafts and put the top draft in. They're just rough drafts. Cut this top line in ready for using the gouge. By cutting the top line in, it helps you keep a nice sharp edge. Selection of gouges, and I'll use the gouge to fit in here the best way it can. I cut the edges in with a gouge, and we can get a little drag line in the middle to give us a guide.
profile of the Corvetto, so I'm going to straighten it up right there now with medium drag. Fine drag now. Thank you. use the rasp just to give it a little sweetness.